question?
We had a tricky first set, and then in the second got tight in the end, had to fight back there. So, I mean, can you just talk through the second set specifically towards the end, how you were able to get the win in straights?
Yeah, I really liked the way that I finished the match because I obviously started it really poorly. Even though I did find myself up a break, I was just making way too many double faults and way too many errors, and just not feeling much of the game. But finished really strong, and I think that's what matters, and actually gives me great confidence that if I was able to play that way, to come through, have a chance in the next one.
In terms of finishing strong, I mean, was there a switch that clicked? Was there a different mindset going into those final three games?
I might have looked at the clock and just thought that this was getting too late.
Fair. Marie, you have Ostapenko next, and you played her really tough in Rome, and you beat her, obviously.
Yeah, it was a tough one.
What are your memories of that match, and what do you make of her game?
It was a real battle, and it could have gone either way. It was a really long physical match, and it was our first ever meeting, so I think it was a chance to see and feel each other's game, and I was really impressed by her game. And she's young and fearless and comes out swinging, and she's a Grand Slam champion, so that speaks for itself, and she's got that experience in Grand Slams already. And I think she likes the matchup of playing against me, and both quite aggressive players, but I do as well.
People use a lot of those words to describe you. Do you see any of yourself in her when you're across the net?
Tennis is a very selfish game, so a lot of it is, as much as you want to focus on certain things and the way your opponent's playing, or there's not a lot of that from my end. I really do focus on improving on my own strengths and improving the weaknesses and figuring it out as the match goes on. But she's definitely, from an aggression point of view and taking the ball early, she's a character as well. So,
Maria, you've played on Ash and you've played on the new Armstrong Stadium. I'm wondering if you could kind of give us a sense of kind of how the new Armstrong compares to Ash.
Yeah, the Armstrong felt a little bit louder. As I said in my first press conference, it just seemed like the pathway is a little bit lower and it's open to the people walking. So I think that just probably creates a little bit more noise, but nothing that is disturbing or different different than any other tournaments that we've played at.
What about court speed?
I'd say, the courts have been a little bit slower, I felt like. Maybe Armstrong is even a little slower than Ash, but I'm the worst person to ask those questions.
You spoke about looking at the time and finishing late here after midnight. How does that aspect of this tournament, which is different from some of the other Grand Slams, change things for you as a player in terms of whether it's recuperation or changing your time clock, things like that, when you do have matches that can stretch into the night?
Right. Okay. I mean, to be honest, in my everyday life, I go to bed very early, and I'm an early riser, so it's quite the opposite of the routine that I've had in the last few days, but it's nothing that is new in terms of knowing what you're going to get at the U.S. Open, and as well as the warm-up tournaments, and when you're looking at now it's in San Jose, but in Stanford, you're playing late, and then you have to come out the next day. Here you have a little bit of a recovery time and a day in between, so, yeah.
How are you feeling physically? It looked like you had a bit of tape on the forearm.
I'm just getting by, yeah.
Same.
Great. It's only week one.
4 days, baby.